Hey people, it's the Pilgrim, and welcome back to Valheim Hearth and Home update. I've made my first sort of traditional style Viking longhouse that I've built in a while. This one I've used all the new Darkwood structures we got with the new update. The exterior looks pretty amazing, but I've done a full sort of interior for it as well, using some of the new items. I've got my little throne there with all my gear around me, money, plenty of weapons and stuff in the boxes. Managed to fit a small sort of bedroom in the corner there. Then we've got a full cooking station with all the new upgrades that come with the cooking pot and the new baking oven, which is pretty cool. And I like the new stone design on the hearth, that looks really good. Got a little cage over there for my wolves. Decked out a table with some food that we might need. Then we've got a full blacksmith's working area with all the upgrades on this side, tons of storage. And on the other side we've got a wooden workbench with all the upgrades you need around that as well. This is a full build tutorial with like every little detail explained. So what I've done at the very end, I've left the interior design in as well, so you can see how I did that. Yeah, I've put some mead barrels in the back there because you need plenty of them for all the potions and stuff. And then up there there's an open roof section to let all the smoke out from the hearth and everything. And then at this end I put in the cartography table and a little bit more storage. And then we've got the sort of obligatory flyby to see the exterior. So when I started thinking about the design for this, I was looking at a lot of like the new Darkwood structures, and I thought the new shingled roofs kind of resemble crow's wings with the, you know, the black sort of diamond shapes on them. So I wanted to sort of mimic that in the roof with the overhangs, and sort of get like those, that sweeping sort of point and the angles going up. And I think it turned out really good. The profile, the base looks amazing. I'm really happy with this one. And I also used a lot of the crow adornments just as little details, like they were holding up the overhangs in different places. And I used as much of the new Darkwood stuff as I could, creating these little windows everywhere and the sort of open roof section at the top to let the smoke out. Yeah, you can see it's a pretty good profile. The overall design is not too complicated. It's quite similar to the very first build I did, actually, just that sort of traditional longhouse shape. But yeah, it's definitely those sort of sweeping overhangs that sort of set it off. Like I said as well, I've done all the interior. That looks pretty cool as well. Right, have fun building, guys, and I will catch you later.
Thank you.
Alright, I'm back. I thought I'd jump on and explain this bit. It'd be a little easier than trying to, you know, do it all through text. Right, the reason I've left these wood iron poles on each end is to snap the old corner roofs to. They're 26 degree old corners. And these are going to build that overhang that's on each section. So there's like six of these all together going across the base. So where that pole sticks up, there should be a snap point just at the top. And the old corner will stick, you know, snap to it. There's actually two of them, and they're going to need a bit of support. So I took these dark wood arches and just snapped them underneath and just angled them so they're like inside the corner roof. And then on each end of the arch, I snapped a wood iron beam. And it might not look like it, but it did give a little extra support because it, when you've got like two of the old corners on, if there's no support at all, the first one turns red. And I think down the middle of the base, it actually just collapses if you try and attach anything to it. So at the moment, it's staying blue, but that'll fade. You can sort of see it turns like orange from green. That's like the indicator that tells you, you know, how much it's got before it collapses, how much load it's bearing. And then you can attach the 45 degree walls to the top. That's why I've left them out on each part, just so you can build that little structure there. It gives it that little extra bit of support. Just below it here, I just used two dark wood beams, two dark wood arches, and then I used 45 degree beams and snapped them to the edge of each of the wood iron beams that are inside there. And that just gives it a little extra support. There you go. And then you can snap the roofs in place, so it's just 45 degree dartwood roofs over the whole base. Except there's a little bit later on where I use the 26 degree roofs in the middle just to make like a small window in the top of the roof, but that's explained later. When it comes to these parts that overhang here, I use the 26 degree roofs hanging off them and then use the 45 degree ones there to go down the side of the roof. So I'm sort of using three 26 degrees, so one there. Then if it'll snap in place, I use two there on that edge and then two 45 degrees. That's pretty much the same for all three overhangs on, well, it's like six overhangs, so it's three on each end. I just changed the way I did the 45s a little bit on the main roof and the middle bit at the top. But you see that in the video, so I'm just going to do the same thing again here. So I'll just snap it in place. It should snap right above the pole. Then the dartwood arches go in. They cover the pole up, sort of angle them so they're inside, so they're not sticking through on the other side. And then it's just two beams, one snap to each side. There you go. And that's it, and then you can put your 45 degree walls in to finish off the roof. Alright, I think that's the only bit I really needed explaining. I'll leave the rest of it to you, like I said, it's all text and stuff. Have fun building, guys, catch you later.